Nancy J with the celebrity spotlight on a man who certainly has a way with words and a way with a guitar, among other instruments. With four albums in his back pocket, he's probably played every single honky-tonk in the U.S. His latest record is K-Mag, Yo-Yo, and Other American Stories. But if you don't know the name Hayes Carll, it is time you meet him. Nice to see you.
It's great to be here.
Mr. Carll. Okay, K-Mag, Yo-Yo. There's got to be a story behind the name of your new album.
There is. K-Mag Yo-Yo is a military acronym for Kiss My Ass, Guys, You're On Your Own.
And yeah.
I thought I would confuse my listeners by throwing something up that nobody knew what it meant. And I succeeded.
I almost thought it was some classical music. I mean, I was thinking of Yo-Yo Ma, and then I was K-Mag. I thought maybe this is a radio station or something.
Yeah, it's like a Yo-Yo Ma with an AK-47 is the kind of thing we're going for sonically.
Okay, and, well, I mean, so what is your relationship to the military? I mean, do you have any type of a military background, or was it just a song that you wanted to?
Yeah, it was more just a song. The full title is K-Mag Yo-Yo and Other American Stories. And so this was one of 12 stories that we told on the record. And this particular one is about a young 19-year-old soldier in Afghanistan. And then it gets a little strange after that, but
it's rocking too. I mean, this is not one of your ballad type drinking songs.
No, this is sort of adrenaline personified musically, is how I describe it. And we'd come up with the song initially, the music, and before I had the words written to it, and I didn't know what it was going to be about, and I thought, what is the sort of the most intense thing that I could envision? And I would play it back and just make stuff up to it, and I just envisioned being in a war zone, and so I wanted to write a story that kind of went along with that music, and so told this one guy's tale.
Daddy joined the Air Force, said it was a good soul. Danger, love, and money, but it only led to divorce. Ended up in Abilene, working at a Dairy Queen. Put me in the Army on the day that I turned 17. Here I am standing in the desert with a gun. Thought I'm going AWOL, but I'm too afraid to run. So I got myself a new plan, stealing from the Taliban.
You really do dabble in a lot of different genres. I mean, you rock, you are honky-tonk, you're Americana, you're country, you're a little pop here and there. How do you describe your music?
I'd call it country folk rock.
Okay.
I guess. I just throw them all together. But, yeah, I mean, I started out as a big country fan, and more than anything, a songwriter fan of guys like Bob Dylan and Kris Kristofferson and Willie Nelson and people that could tell stories in a way that was engaging to me, and that's what got my imagination running at first, and I wanted to be able to do that, and that's what got me into music, and then the rest is sort of I explore it and figure it out as I go.
So you're born and bred Texan.
Yes.
So Texas songwriter, that kind of itself is a label, because for some reason people think Texans have a different way with words. Do you agree with that? I mean, what does Texas songwriter mean? I mean, you don't hear Massachusetts songwriter or Oregon songwriter.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. I've been asked a lot, you know, why so many great writers come from Texas, whether it's country or blues or folk. You know, everybody from Buddy Holly to Lightnin' Hopkins to Willie Nelson. The list is literally endless. I don't know what the trick is. You know, it's a huge state, and you can't say it's one geographical thing, because being from Lubbock is a completely different thing than being from Galveston, where Barry White or George Jones come from. You know, it's a completely different vibe. But you know, there's something about maybe that sort of unlimited potential and letting your imagination run free.
What do you know now that you didn't know then when you started out doing your own record?
That's about the business or life
and
in general?
Just life in general. I mean, everything. I mean, yourself, the business. Because you laughed. There must be some story there.
Oh, yeah, there's just too many to. That's for the book. I guess I've learned over the years that the most important thing is, you know, doing what you love. I wouldn't have made it this far if I didn't, and it's not something that It's a great job, but like any job, it's got its ups and downs. And trying to surround yourself with good people is important, like in any walk of life. And believing in what you do. At the end of the day, I figure, you know, success and celebrity can come and go, but as long as you're proud of what you've done, and as long as I'm proud of the songs that I've written and the way that I treated people, that I'll be able to sleep well at the end of the day and be proud of what I did. And so I try and go through the whole ride, the whole roller coaster of being in the music business by working hard at what I do and having things that at the end of the day I can say I'm proud of this piece of work.
Well, you can say you're proud of this piece of work, but isn't it difficult to make a living at this?
Yeah.
Has that been tough?
Yeah, certainly. And that's why you have to love it, because if it was something that I didn't love, I would have quit a long time ago. Because, you know, I mean, it's been a gradual climb and success over the years. But I spent a lot of years, you know, sleeping on couches and playing to drunks while they had bar fights for $5 a night, and driving 10 hours to be at a canceled gig in Lampasas or Cleveland or something, you know. And so it's one of those things where, but I loved all that. That's what I wanted. I wanted to travel. I wanted to meet all these crazy people and do this. And if I didn't have that level of enjoyment for it, it's not for everybody.
Your records are fun to listen to. I mean, K-Mag Yo-Yo is just, it's just fun because it just takes you on a ride. But also then you have songs that you wrote for Country Strong, the Gwyneth Paltrow, Tim McGraw movie, right? Now, how did you get involved with that?
The music supervisor who arranges all the music for the movies and in this case had to pick out hundreds of songs, was a fan of mine, and so he came. I went to my record label and asked for some songs that I'd recorded for a previous project and liked them, and then asked me to write some more tunes, which I did, and then he turned down. So I just ended up basically through a guy who was a fan who happened to be able to put me in that position, so it was a really cool experience though, because I got to go up and meet all the actors and work with the director and sort of watch Garrett Hedlund become this character that was sort of roughly it was like a better looking, more talented version of me.
Oh, you know? Okay, I got so it. Yeah.
It was a really cool experience. Got to dance with Gwyneth Paltrow.
Oh, nice.
And talk to Tim McGraw about music and acting, and so it was fun for me, because I spend most of my time in bars, clubs, honky tonks, theaters, all over the place, and talking to people who've usually had a few too many drinks and don't really have that much to say by that point in the night. And so it was nice to get to talk to these really creative people about how they do their work and get to watch them do it.
Any acting aspirations?
I would love to. I haven't gotten any calls yet.
Okay, well, you never know. You know, that's... That's right. As many people as going to see this, we may see some casting directors out there. So you're available, in other words.
Yeah, okay. I'm wide open.
Well, I'm glad you are. Thank you so much that you were able to clear your schedule to come here to XTV to talk to us.
It's been my pleasure.
Appreciate it. You're a lot of fun. More people need to know who you are. And that's why I am here to tell you to look for Hayes Carll in your power zone. K-Mag Yo-Yo, Hayes Carll.